So let's see the Impala architecture, how it is helping us to get almost near real-time queries, and how it compares with Hive. Let's have a look at it. So in the slide, if I go about. So what is Impala? It is a general purpose SQL engine. So it's a pure SQL engine that is debatable, in the sense like you cannot say that Impala is 100% real time, in the sense like you cannot Impala with your RDBMS systems or something. I will put Impala in a position where you can have interactive queries, not real time, but interactive. Interactive means you run a query, it's not like you will be waiting for hours to get the result. Mostly you can get the results in minutes or even less than that. It has a massive parallel processing database engine developed by Cloudera. So Impala has its own execution engine. It does not convert your queries to MapReduce. So this is the most important point. When you are having Hive, with Kudu, it's probably near real time, but Kudu is still experimental. I mean, it is very new. But if you are not using Kudu, if you put it directly on top of HDFS, right, then it is like near real time or interactive, I can say. Integrated into Hadoop stack on the same level as MapReduce and not above it as Hive and Pig. So this is the point you have to understand. Impala sits directly on top of HDFS. It is not something which is converting your queries into MapReduce, right? So let's see the points further, whatever we have in Impala. So it's a general purpose SQL query engine, works for both analytical and transactional workloads. Supports queries that take from milliseconds to hours. So the queries actually depend on your data, right? Say for example, the problem with Hive is, let's say you are having a file which has, say, how do I say? Let's say you are having a table which has 10,000 rows. Just an example, 10,000 rows. If I write a Hive query, it will still take some time because Hive has to get the metadata, convert it into a MapReduce program. The MapReduce program has to run. So even though my table is having, say, 10,000 rows, my Hive query is going to take at least some minutes to give me the result. But when I do the same thing in Impala, I can probably get the answer in milliseconds or less than a second because of the size of the data. But if I'm having a table having billions of rows, or let's say terabytes of data, if I use Impala, probably I cannot get it in milliseconds or something, probably a couple of minutes, but it is still faster than, much faster than Hive with MapReduce, okay? It runs directly within Hadoop, so it can read widely used Hadoop file formats, can talk to HDFS, Kudu, and any other storage managers. It runs on the same node that runs Hadoop processes. So basically, when you install Impala, Impala gets installed on the data nodes. So we will be having data nodes, right? And then it will get installed on top of the data nodes. And it is having a higher performance. So it's written in C++ instead of Java. Remember, Hadoop and the siblings are all in Java. They are written in Java. Impala is written in C++. It has runtime code generation, completely new execution engine. There is no MapReduce. So you can consider Impala something like Oracle. So does, if you write an Oracle query in Oracle, does Oracle convert it into MapReduce? No, Oracle has nothing to do with MapReduce, right? So imagine you bring Oracle on top of Hadoop. Something similar to that. That is how Impala can be compared. And we will come to the other details of Impala. Just hold on. It provides fast interactive queries, we know that. It uses the same metadata, SQL syntax, ODBC driver, and UI as Apache Hive. So the point is, if you want to use Impala, Hive should be already installed in the system. Well, you can avoid it, but in most of the cases, what people do is that they will already have a Hive installation, and then they will use Impala on top of that. Why? Because Impala actually uses the same meta store that is used by Hive. Remember how Hive is storing the metadata? Hive has a meta store service, right? So if you have gone through your Hive classes, you will remember this. Hive has a meta store. So typically it will be something like MySQL or PostgreSQL, where Hive is storing all the metadata. The same metadata is used by Impala, which means if you are creating a table in Hive, you can query the same table using Impala, which will naturally make you ask the question, can Impala replace Hive, or you know, then why do we need a Hive? And I will come to that answer in a moment. It is an addition to tools available for querying big data. Impala doesn't replace frameworks such as Hive. So naturally, you will have a question, if Impala is so good, right? Why it cannot probably replace Hive? The answer is very simple. If I write a Hive query, okay, what are the chances that the query will fail in the middle of execution? This is the question. Okay, we'll wrap it. It can never fail, 100%. You can never ever fail a Hive query. Why am I saying that a Hive query will never fail? Is there a reason, or I'm simply posting that it will not fail? Why the Hive query will not fail? So basically, it's very simple. Because when you write a Hive query, right, it gets converted into a MapReduce program. So that's for sure, right? And you can never ever fail, have failed MapReduce. I mean, worst case scenario, fail, that's not. MapReduce is fault tolerant. So what I was telling you is that it is very, very rare that a MapReduce job will fail, okay? And accordingly, it is very rare that your Hive query will fail, because ultimately your Hive queries are getting converted into MapReduce program. This means if I have to create a Hive query, so let's say you're doing an ETL job, just an example, okay? So let's say you are running an ETL job, and let's say that job is taking some 2 hours or 3 hours to complete, and you are using Hive in the middle, okay? That means there is very rare chance that the job will fail, because Hive is never going to fail. That's good, actually. But Impala, on the other hand, cannot guarantee this. Impala doesn't convert it into MapReduce, okay? It streams the intermediate results, meaning whatever query is running, let's say on 10 machines or 20 machines, the whatever query you are running using Impala, okay, the results are actually streamed between the machines, which means if one of the machine crashes, okay, if one of the machine crashes, the whole Impala query will fail. You cannot have possibly fault tolerance in Impala. But in case of Hive, you can have fault tolerance. So the question will be that where will I be using Hive and where will I be using Impala? It's actually very simple, right? Say for example, if you are having very long running queries, let's say your queries are taking a lot of time, okay? And then in that particular case, you should be using Hive, okay? Because you don't want, you know, you don't really want the queries to fail at any point in time. If the query fails, you have to restart from the beginning. But if you are having a lesser amount of data and your queries in Impala probably takes 5 minutes of time to complete, then probably use Impala. Because even if the query fails, right, even if the query fails in the middle of 5 minutes, you can restart the query. It's perfectly fine, right? So understand this point that Impala cannot guarantee what? Fault tolerance. You cannot have fault tolerance in Impala, but on the other hand, Hive is fault tolerant. So it is a call that you have to take whether you should be using Impala or Hive. It is completely up to you to decide which tool you will be using. But like I said, Impala can never give you fault tolerance because it is streaming the results in the middle. Okay. So that is this last point saying Hive and other frameworks built on MapReduce are best suited for long running batch jobs, such as those involving batch processing, ETL type jobs. But Impala streams, and that is why Impala is not probably a good candidate for that. So what are the benefits of Impala? Familiar SQL interface, ability to interactively query data in Hadoop. You can have distributed queries. Yes, Impala has to be there on all the nodes. Ability to share data files between different components. Single system for all the ETL jobs you can do. Now, comparing Impala with Hive, right? How can you compare Impala with Hive, right? Impala is SQL on HDFS. Well, Hive is SQL on Hadoop. What does this actually mean, right? SQL on HDFS means directly you are querying the data in HDFS. SQL on Hadoop means you are converting it into MapReduce. Impala uses a custom MPP engine, where Hive uses MapReduce, we know that. No MapReduce overhead in case of Impala, while Hadoop has the same. Impala is not fault tolerant, while Hive is fault tolerant. So that is the advantage of using Hive. MapReduce materializes intermediate results, which enables better scalability and fault tolerance. Impala streams intermediate results. Impala is recommended for real-time queries, while Hive is for batch jobs. Hive generated query expressions at compile time, where Impala does runtime code generation. So these are basically the differences between Impala and Hive. Now I will share you some hands-on codes which you can run on Impala, but basically I don't want to go through the hands-on part of Impala, because it is exactly the same as Hive. I will show you it. I will show you Impala. But basically, creation of a table, running a query, doing a join operation, everything is same as Hive. There is no difference between Hive and Impala from the point of writing a query. The only difference is how they execute your query, actually. Okay? Now, So let's have a quick look at Impala, then we will come back to this. So if I have to show you Impala, it's very simple actually. If you go to query editors, there is Impala. Okay, in the hue. This is Impala. But before that, let's go to Hive first. So I'm going to go to Hive first. So this is our Hive. And in here, just an example, okay? Let's go to some table. So let's say we do a select count star from EX and okay, transactions 100. So I'm just running a very simple query, select count star from transactions 100. Okay, very simple Hive query. Yes, you can use a CLI also for him, but I'll just show you from the GUI. So I'm running a very simple Hive query. I'm doing a select count star, and the results are here. Right? 50,000, right? So the answer is 50,000. And we took around 36 seconds to run this query using Hive. If I do the same thing with Impala, it should be lesser. So I am on Impala and you see everything is same, you know, there is no difference. And if I say run this, so we took around 36 seconds, I think. And here it took 5 seconds. Look at the time taken, it is 5 seconds, right? So compared with 36 seconds, it's like 5 seconds, very, very less. But again, since Impala is running in a cluster, ideally, you know, you should give enough resources for Impala to work, right? You cannot run Impala queries on Hive. What I did just now is that this is a Hive table. I ran it on a Hive table only. So this table you see, this transaction 100 is a Hive table. See, Impala can connect to Hive Metastore. So all these tables that you see here are Hive tables actually. Okay, you can also create your own table in Impala, which will get stored in Hive Metastore only. So they share the same metadata basically. So this transactions 100 is a Hive table, which I ran just now. Okay, so basically you see that the queries are faster, but it is not blazingly fast because I am running it on a virtual machine. But let's look at some more things, okay, related to Impala, which, you know, Impala queries on Hive tables. I just ran the Impala query on a Hive table on only. So I will just show you this. So what is transaction 100? What is transaction 100? Can I say it's a table? This is the table, right? This is a sample table, right? And where is this table? It is a Hive table. This table is created in Hive only. It's a Hive table. And I'm running that using Impala. So this is an Impala query, right? And I'm running this query on Hive table. Yeah, yeah. So I'm running that query on the Hive table. So this is a Hive table only. This transaction 100 is a Hive table. And you can access the Hive table from Impala basically. This is basically what I meant. But couple of more things which you have to be aware of Impala is that there are three major daemons that are associated with Impala. So there is something called an Impala daemon, there is state store, there is metastore. So when you are installing Impala, or if it is already installed, right, there is a daemon called Impala D, or we call it as the Impala daemon. So this Impala D will be running on every data node. Every data node will have this Impala D, or the Impala daemon we call it, right? Now this daemon is responsible for running your queries. Okay, so inside Impala D you have a query planner, query coordinator, and query execution engine. So the execution engine actually executes your query. I will talk about planner and coordinator later. And then what happens, you will have a Hive Metastore, which will be used by Impala. There is also somebody called Impala Statestore. So first, let's look at this Impala Daemon. So the Impala Daemon runs on each data node where Impala is installed. It is represented by an actual process named Impala D. Impala D is responsible for processing the queries which are submitted through either the shell API or either through a third party application. A query can be submitted to any Impala D running on any node, and that particular node serves as a coordinator node. So this is the important point. So what is going to happen? Let's say you are submitting a query. Now there will be a lot of data nodes in your cluster. One of the data node where Impala is running will take your query, and that node will become your coordinator node. Okay, so in this particular picture you can see that the middle machine is the coordinator node. Why? Because it just accepted the query. And then it is the responsibility of the middle machine or the middle node to find out the other nodes where the data is residing and then execute the query and get the final result and show you the result. Which means if I'm having hundreds of data nodes in a Hadoop cluster, you can submit as many queries as you want, and one of the machine will pick the query and that will be responsible for running your query. And that node is called a coordinator node. So if you are running 1,000 queries, there will be 1,000 coordinator node. Each query will be accepted by one coordinator node, basically. Now what is this state store? So this is something which is kind of like important. The state store is responsible for checking health of each Impala D and then relaying each Impala daemon health to other daemons frequently. So the problem in Impala is that the machines do not talk to each other. If there is one Impala D, it will not normally talk to another Impala D, which means one Impala D may not be knowing the health status of another Impala D. So how do you know the status of other machines? That is through the state store. So what happens, every machine will convey its health status to the state store. State store is a process, and state store will then distribute this to other machines. Actually, it is a single running process and can run on the same node where the Impala server or any other node within the cluster is running. The name of the state store is state store D. Every Impala daemon process interacts with the state store, providing its latest health status, and this information is relayed within the cluster to each and every Impala daemon. In the event of a node failure due to any reason, state store updates all other nodes about this failure, and once such a notification is available to other Impala D, no other daemon assign any further queries to the affected node. So just go through this slide once so that you understand the importance of state store. So basically what the slide is saying is that every Impala D or every Impala daemon will relay its status to the state store, and state store will relay the status to other daemons. So state store will act as a middleman, actually, you know. So it will collect the health information from everybody and pass it to all the others. So that is basically what the state store is doing. So this is how the architecture will look like. Have a look at here and please go through the slide. This is basically the same thing which I have explained. Typically when you run, so it goes to the resource manager, but resource manager is not responsible for running your query. It just sends to one of the, what you say, Impala Ds. Whichever Impala D is there, it just sends to one of the Impala Ds. Yes, this Impala D is there on every data node. Every data node will have one Impala D. Look at this picture, it will become very clear to you. See, typically in a Hadoop cluster, what we do is that we will assign a single master machine for everything. For example, your name node, resource manager, Hive meta store, state store D, or if anything else is there, all the master daemons will be in one machine, even H master. They all will be running on one machine. So state store D is shown on the name node in this picture. That doesn't mean like it should be always on the name node, but ideally the recommended configuration is that we bring all the master machines in one particular node actually. Okay, now the important point here is that if the state store D or if the state store process crashes, still Impala will work. It's not a critical process actually, right? But the problem is that if the state store is down, then the Impala machines do not understand the health of each other, right? Because they don't know what is the health of the other guy. So if you submit a query, they may assume everybody is healthy and try to run the query may fail. So it is recommended that the state store should be running ideally. Okay. Now what about the metadata? How Impala is able to get the metadata? Impala uses traditional MySQL or PostgreSQL databases to store table definitions. So basically it uses the same Hive metastore, which might be either in MySQL or PostgreSQL. The important details such as table and column information and table definitions are stored in metastore. Apache Hive also shares the same database for its metastore, because of which Impala can access the tables created or loaded by Hive if all the table columns use supported data types. Besides that, Impala also maintains information about the data files stored on HDFS. Very important point. Impala tracks information about file metadata, that is the location of blocks. So what Impala actually does, this is a very important point, is that Impala actually talks to your name node, because name node understands, name node is the only guy who knows files, blocks and locations, and Impala collects this file metadata also so that the queries can run faster, right? So Impala has the metadata from Hive that has data like table definition, data types and all. It also has the metadata from name node, the location of files, blocks, everything, so that if you fire a query, Impala need not even check with the name node to run the query. Okay. Zookeeper, not keep, Impala doesn't work with Zookeeper. It works independently, right? Yes, if you create a table in Impala, you can even access it from Hive as well, because they work using the same metastore. But the important point here is that the metadata is stored in a fashion that it keeps Hive metadata, it also keeps a copy of your HDFS metadata, which makes your queries really, really faster. I am actually using the Cloudera VM, which got downloaded from the Cloudera website. It comes with Impala by default. On your training VM, if you have to ensure whether Impala is installed or not. Now look at this point. This is probably the most important point. Each Impala machine caches all the metadata locally, which can expedite the process of gathering metadata for a large amount of data. Very important point. Each Impala machine has a local copy of the entire metadata of the cluster. That means if I write a query and say submit to Impala, Impala need not talk to name node, Impala need not talk to Hive. Every machine has a local copy of the metadata, which means the queries are blazingly fast.
I'm sure you enjoyed learning from this video. Please like the video And if you have any doubts regarding this video, please comment us in the comment section. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more such informative videos. Do look out for other related videos in our playlist. For more information, visit our website now. Keep learning with Intellipaat.